One of the premiums in the special collection of DVDs will be a reproduction of the locket that was a Horcrux in the films. The locket was a very sort of a really lovely brief to have. But it was sort of a challenge because it was full of evil, but it kind of needed to have this beauty to it and something appealing and something historical.
I have stolen the real Horcrux and intend to destroy it.
The Slytherin locket was based on an 18th century Spanish piece of jewellery that I saw in a museum, and then I developed it from there. I loved the idea that the crystal on the front of it had a depth to it and was faceted, so it was almost like there were lots of different sides and you didn't quite know which bit of it was going to open. And then once you open it, there's another sort of chamber inside that would then house the little tiny piece of parchment. And we put lots of tiny writing in that, so that crossed over into our work as graphic designers. So it was a real sort of marriage of different craftsmen that played in this. And every detail on that locket I was allowed to play with. So even the loop that goes onto the chain is a little snake wound round, and the jewels are green for Slytherin. And the great thing on Harry Potter is that this was all manufactured on site, so discussions could take place with the prop maker about the right materials to use and perhaps alter the design a little bit to go with that. So the locket was a treat to conjure up. And now to know that the fans can also have ownership of a little bit of that experience by having this reproduction piece in the collectible DVD set is wonderful, and I hope I get to have one too.